gone into the area if Asaba can find him, and he has. It's Galloway, good control, and he tests Weaver, who has to push it away for the corner.
And that's very, very unlucky. It's a good strike as well from Galloway. I don't know if you notice, Whitley, again, he slipped over early on, and suddenly Galloway gets a bit of luck there on his left peg, bang, good stop from the keeper.
And Dickoff. Saffold, the challenge by Cook. Played back to him by Dickoff. Oh!
What a save, Rob. What a save this is. Horrocks made a real deep run here. Dickoff does well, he holds it up. Suddenly Southall gets in problem. Look at Dickoff. Slips it outside to Cook. Takes a touch. Horlock thinks, here we go, 1-0. What a save from Bartram.
And here they are now on this level playing field. Gillingham looking to get into the first division for the first time in their history. And Asaba has Taylor breaking to his left. Opts instead for Hessenthaler. Now it's Taylor. And now Asaba is offside. The flag is up, it won't count.
Just wondering here, Rob, does Carlos Asaba make the wrong choice? Suddenly, Gillingham break, they'll get two against two. The ball's at Asaba's feet. I think, look at the run behind them from Taylor. If he'd have held on to it a little bit longer, Hessenthaler spots him. Thought the big fella was going to head it. Tries to drive it, definitely offside.
Well, he didn't even celebrate. His instant reaction was to look to the assistant referee. And Asaba knew immediately that he was to be disappointed. Making progress. Oh, it was a really tricky one for Patterson to deal with. And it was Edgehill who came storming in.
Well, suddenly, it's the first time we've seen Edgehill in such an advanced position. But what a good ball this is. Gillingham were looking for offside here. No flag. That's a teasing ball in the box. Great ball, in fact. And it just maybe if Edgehill could have headed it back across goal. Gota was there lurking.
Edgehill. Looking for Dickoff. Cook has gone up on the outside and he's found him. Terry Cook looking for Gota. Ashby doesn't make it. And it's hit the post from Sean Gota.
Well, that just... believe it, when Ashby missed it and Gota suddenly chucked out his left leg, I thought if he'd have cut it back, Dickoff could have had a tap in. City fans can't believe it, this is great play. Dickoff clips it to Cook, delightful ball, but look at Dickoff. And you have to say Gota's unlucky. Had he squared it across here, I think Dickoff has a tap in.
Dickoff. Almost gave Patterson the slip. It's fallen for Cook. Brilliantly turned over.
That's a great right hand from Vince Bartram. No wonder he's smiling. That's a fine save. Great play from Dickoff. Originally started off with Weaver with a throw out.
And here's Ian Bishop. Horlock lets it run. Good defending by Saunders. Bob Taylor. Now Tony Ball, given away to Southall.
I think Hessenthaler was a little bit lucky, a little bit fortunate early on because he dived into Edgehill for me. But Mark Halsey decided advantage, go on.
Asaba playing it on to Smith. Taylor's at the edge of the area, but he's worked it through. It's Carlos Asaba, and it's a goal in the last 10 minutes of the contest. Could it be the goal that takes Gillingham into the first division for the first time in their history and dents Manchester City's dream of an immediate return?
Would you believe it? Asaba, we know he's got bundles of ability. Carried on the run and he sent Kent into ecstasy. Surely now Gillingham are marching in to Division 1. It's a lovely ball from Asaba. Smith doesn't panic. Gets a little bit of luck there. It's a toe poke. Weaver goes to ground. But Smith, who's been more adventurous, getting forward. Asaba, great finish with his right foot. Smacks into the back of the net. Weaver can do nothing. What a great strike from Carlos Asaba. Weaver, just the pace of it. City. Carl Asaba's goal so late in the game, possibly a fatal blow to Manchester City. Gota. They have to find a way through somehow. Can Crooks deliver for them? In comes Richard Edgehill. Dickoff! Oh, saved by the feet of the goalkeeper.
Well, unbelievable. Dickoff, the bit of save. Wow, foiled by his best man. What a game Bartram's had.
And Asaba here is onside, but not too keen to rush things. Nothing gung-ho from Gillingham at this stage of the game.
City fans all around the stadium at home. How tough does this get?
Carl Asaba, the goal scorer. And it's Taylor he's put through this time. Taylor, 2-0! Gillingham are surely there now, making history in the process.
Well, Rob, we said they were always a threat, the way they play as a pair. Goals this season between them has been special, 42 goals, now it's 44. And what a good finish from Robert Taylor. Quick thinking here from Asaba, the touch is not bad, but this is brilliant. Taylor gets away from Vaughan, 20 yards out, right foot, drills it low. And that is bye-bye Division 2 for Gillingham. Division 1, here we come. Brilliant back heel. Tony Vaughan can't get there. Keeps it low, off the greasy turf. And Tony Pulis knows, now we're safe. Surely that is it.
Well, Vince Bartram made a crucial save at a key point in the game from Paul Dickoff, and he is the nationwide man of the match.
It's a cruel game. Bartram, the pot and champagne, whereas Dickoff.
And Gota's through here. Great challenge. But the follow-up shot is in. And Manchester City have given themselves some late hope here through the goal from Horlock.
Well. Could City somehow hold themselves back? It's a beautiful little flick from Dickoff. Suddenly Gota looks to be scoring. Horlock arrives. Keeps it low, drives up his left peg, past man of the match, Bartram. Just when Gota fought a chance, Horlock arrives, keeps it low.
There are 5 minutes of stoppage time to be added. Not over till the final whistle, and City here looking for an opening. It's Dickoff again!
City just come back from the dead. Unbelievable. And Paul Dickoff, wow. Gota goes to ground. Dickoff, right footed, beats his best pal, high into the net with his right foot. Can't believe it. And the other half of Manchester goes wild. On the right foot, just sticks it right at the top corner between the post and the crossbar. And glory for Dickoff, who was foiled earlier. Bartram, not this time. City fans can't believe it. What a match.
An outstanding comeback that takes an outstanding second division playoff final into extra time. Attacking, looking for Dickoff! Headed straight into the goalkeeper's hands.
What a chance, what a ball from Horlock. Taylor does well, gives it Horlock, and this is glorious chance, slightly behind him.
For the first time, the second division playoff final has gone to penalties, and now for Tony Pulis and Joe Royal, it's the lottery. It's Horlock against Vince Bartram. City are one up. Paul Smith
who takes Gillingham's first spot kick. And it's saved by Weaver! But Paul Dickoff here has the opportunity to give City a healthy 2-0 lead in the shootout. And it hit the post and stayed out. Unbelievable. Can Adrian Penick now draw Gillingham level? Really would put the pressure on Gillingham's next taker if Edgehill could score here. And he does! If Guy Butters misses this penalty, Manchester City will be in the first division next season. Gillingham will stay in Division 2. He has missed it! Manchester City are up! They did it the hard way, but Nicky Weaver calls them forward for the celebrations. Celebrations that are fully merited for the way they fought their way back into it. He can hardly contain himself. Look at him. It's been an extraordinary way to do it, but Manchester City are there. They are the genuine soap opera club. Cliffhangers upon cliffhangers. In their fall down the table, they were 2-0 down in this contest. They fought their way back to 2-2 in extra time. And now, by virtue of a 3-1 victory on penalties, they are there. They've completed one small step on their road back to the Premiership. Joe Royle's team have done it. It's Manchester City who are the second division playoff winners of 1999.